Hello and welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Fernando Castillo, and I'm responsible for the SAP business at AWS. Super excited to be today with you and share kind of the latest things we're doing at AWS to support customers and what the customer different journeys that they're adopting to run their SAP solutions. I mean, run that, how can we helping customers innovate faster? So we'll have a few slides and then I'll open for Q&A. So let's keep starting. So the first thing is that I wanted to share with you is that SAP and AWS have been working for a number of years on primarily all cloud-related topics, right? Back in the day, in 2008, SAP became a customer from us, started utilizing our services, and through time, not only SAP themselves, but also customers started adopting. And we went through multiple industry first with SAP. We certified the first instances, the first cloud native instances. We started to support every single SAP's solution on non-HANA databases when HANA didn't even exist, right? Then we jumped and created the first HANA instances on the cloud with our X1 cloud native instance that started with 2 TB. And as time progressed, you know, customers will continue to adopt these SAP solutions on AWS. As the journey continued, SAP started to develop all their innovation platforms, so SAP Cloud Platform running on AWS, and we collaborated with SAP in how to help customers adopt more the cloud with our different programs like the fast migration. Not only that, but SAP SaaS properties through that time also started adopting AWS to power them, like Concur, for instance. If we keep moving through time, we announced the largest instances for SAP S/4HANA, high commitment there, all the way to 24 scale up and 48 scale out. You know, the only cloud provider in the world that is allowing, is being certified by SAP to run in those environments. And the journey continues, right? We're seeing more and more SAP solutions, being deployed on the AWS. So if you can just think about it, we start with IIS, right? Infrastructure as a Service. Then we progress to all the innovation layer that SAP has been deploying for customers. Then we are helping customers leverage AWS native services. And finally, we have SAP creating solutions to integrate and support customers that run SAP on AWS. So fantastic partnership through the years that is aimed to support customers. And talking about customers, just to let you know, last year we hit an interesting milestone. We today have over 5,000 active AWS customers running SAP solutions on AWS. And more than half of these customers are running SAP HANA-based solutions. So it's a fantastic testament of the trust, and we're humble of the trust that customers put on us, and how they, through all these different years, they have been adopting AWS to run their most mission-critical solutions on a platform that is providing them multiple services. And as you can see, a number of large organizations, this is across every single geo, across every single industry, you see customers adopting more and more the cloud and SAP solutions on AWS. So one of the latest, you know, customers, three customers were with us on our previous conference in reInvent December last year, and kind of putting here some of the quotes, right, of the power and the value that AWS is providing for SAP customers. Our friend Michael Martin from Heineken shared with us that, you know, running 42 TB system is for them half the cost of running 6 TB that they used to have on premises. So it's really, really a strong testament on the value that they're providing. Engie, another amazing customer, Frederick from Engie, was sharing with us that how we are helping resize databases and reduce the databases from 4 to 2 and the flexibility that we have around that. Mark from HP shared with us, you know, they really wanted to pay for what they needed. And, you know, other environments, private cloud or other environments, didn't allow him to have that flexibility. It was definitely something that they got and from AWS. So kind of perspective on what customers see. Of course, each customer has a whole story behind them and definitely value that they're obtaining from running their SAP solutions on AWS. The question in mind is, what sets AWS apart? And I want to dive a little bit deep into this topic. We see kind of fundamental things that are setting AWS apart and why all these customers and more are coming to the platform. Primary is, you know, when you think about HANA, is our commitment to cloud native, right? We make the decision to really invest in our Nitro platform. I will talk a little bit about what that means, but it's basically how we can scale and how we can provide high level of compute and really pass the whole instances to SAP customers. And this is allowing us to really be able to be certified by SAP to run scale-out environments. Of course, the HANA support, right? HANA being a primary topic from in the number of customers' minds, and of course SAP, how we're supporting that, right? And how we are supporting the 48 and 100 terabytes for analytics. Certifications, we have been working, as I shared earlier, with SAP since the early beginning, certifying a number of solutions, a number of platforms. So that's definitely a strong point that customers say, hey, you have this amazing place where they can have all these different instances that are fully certified by SAP. We have been innovating quite a bit with SAP, and you will see in further slides, right, from the cloud platform, having multiple services, having more regions supporting SAP cloud platform, to working very close with companies like NS2 for the public sector in the US, Concur, Qualtrics, and many others, and how SAP is putting innovation on top of AWS to help customers connect these two worlds. This could not come to fruition without a strong partner community. We are very diligent on our partners, right, and certified partners for SAP, so definitely important programs that we have been running through years to make sure the partners that are doing SAP on AWS have the right qualifications. And of course, the global coverage, right? We are consistent across the world into what we provide SAP customers. So let's go a deeper layer on this one. So what is Nitro? Why Nitro is important? So basically what we invested heavily is we understood that, you know, virtualized and hypervisor environments had a limit and then has a taxation to customers where they cannot, you know, obtain the whole power of performance of an instance. So we've been working for years now, and we created all that virtualization layer in a silicon. So it's a chip that goes into, in a simple way, it's a chip that goes into the instance. And what allows that to do is to provide to the customer the whole performance of the instances, but not only that, allow us to connect with every single AWS service that we have on the platform today. And today we have more than 175. To give you an example, of the art of the possible in this environment. We had one of our colleagues doing an exercise and sharing this at TechEd Live, at TechEd a year ago or so, a live demo, where he was telling Alexa to change the size of from a 1 terabyte HANA instance to a 9 terabyte HANA instance, from a one that has a hypervisor to the one that has Nitro. It took them around 10 minutes to do the switch with voice, no other things. Why? Because everything's interconnected. So think about all the features that you can start connecting with your SAP instances. So it's fascinating technology. Customers are rallying around that, and it's giving them a lot of value on not only the integration, but the performance they can get from the systems. As we continue through more details, support, right? This is just a snapshot of the instances we have on scale-up solutions. We announced last year 18 and 24 on scale-up environment, so customers can go from any size, resize. And we have a number of customers that we have through years that they started small, but they continue to grow, and they need to have the peace of mind that they will have environment that will support them. So you see the whole range of instances we can support them. Not only that, but we also can scale out, right? If you want to be higher, of course we can do. And for VW, you can go all the way, as mentioned before, to 100 terabytes. So it's really, really robust platform that we're working on supporting customers on that. But again, as I mentioned earlier, it's not only about, you know, the platform, it's about the coverage, right, where we are and the regions we support, but it's also how SAP is coming and working with us to enable the innovation via their SAP Cloud Platform. So today, right, SAP provides that platform in 12 different hyperscaler regions, and 10 out of those are AWS. So you can see that it's only, you know, we have a big coverage working with SAP, but not only coverage, we also have more services. So this is helping customers, you know, not only run their SAP environments or ECC S4, but also innovate on top of that, making sure all is on the same cloud environments. As we continue, there's a number of things that we have been doing with SAP, right? We did HANA Cloud, we are doing SAP Data Warehouse Cloud, Analytics. We also, SAP started connecting with us, and we are right now doing IoT integrations, which means that you can run IoT code on the SAP Cloud Platform and connect directly with AWS Native Services. So all that business logic, all those different integration points are already done by SAP for customers that want to integrate both IoT and from AWS and SAP. Data custodian, another interesting thing, if you're interested in GDPR, how to have policies and manage GDPR and any other type of regulatory protocols, data custodian can do that and work for SAP customers run on AWS. Also, on the other side, as I mentioned, you have SAP Cloud Platform running AWS, Concur, Qualtrics, and a number of other SAP solutions. So going back to my early points, you saw the IIS portion, any database supported. Of course, big investments on HANA. We're supporting the HANA roadmap, but we don't stay there. We are working very close with SAP to make sure that they can be customers that run on AWS can innovate and can create new solutions and integrate with our services. So as we continue our presentation, the next portion that I wanted to elaborate is if you're thinking about running SAP, right, we can support you. And this is kind of the key message here. There are a number of things you would like to do. We can support all of them. So what is the SAP transformation journey that most of customers at you might be facing is really making sure that your transformations and your implementation were successful, right? There's data from what the challenge has been through time about integration and implementation of SAP solutions. Of course, we have SAP HANA adoption is going through stages and customers are adopting more, customers telling more that, business case is needed. Now, some of them say it's not a priority. Some of them believe there's a maturity problem. So how do we help customers in this complexity and environment? So one of the things we're trying to do is, helping customers re-architect and really evolve the architecture to a microservice, understanding that SAP will still be this cornerstone of their solution. So how do we help customers innovate and expand their SAP solutions and really get all the benefits they're looking for SAP solutions? So one of the things we are working on very close, and we have a number of customers on this, is really make sure that we create the core clean. Clean core is super important, right? Yeah, customers like you that have been experiencing this through years have experienced the challenges of, updating and making sure if you create anything attached to the core, that creates challenges down the road. So we're talking about having a clean core and integrating that with microservices, either via route, AWS native route or an SAP Cloud Platform route, again, working very close with SAP, to create a system of differentiation, right? Really help customers address your address with AWS integration with SAP, with microservices. How do we really help revenue grow? How do we, at the end of the day, reduce operational overhead? In other words, how we help you digital transform, right? How do we help you enable your better customer experience, and how we take the best of both of those technologies and the partnership we have with SAP to allow and enable this in a way that you can innovate faster, in a way that you can try new things, in a way that you can really start testing and move fast in this world. For that, we have collaborated with SAP, and we have SAP has created a business architecture that, of course, you can see there is integrating both the SAP solutions and AWS applications and really the platform services to make sure that both worlds interconnect and both worlds provide, at the end of the day, the best solutions for our joint customers. And there's a path for innovation. There's a path for them to accelerate their own business, which at the end of the day is what's important for any customer. As we move forward, right, and as we have seen that working with multiple customers in every single industry, you see an example here, is how these two worlds come together. We have dedicated teams that have been working on this for all these industries, and you see some examples on the retail space, on the manufacturing space, on CPG space, that really are working together to make sure these joint solutions are working in a way that will create value for you as our customers. So how do we accelerate transformations. So you saw the framework, you saw what are things we're seeing, but how you can get there? That's a question that is on top of any number of customers, right? So, you know, a number of customers have a cloud-first strategy, but spend still on the cloud. So that's kind of the biggest thing, how to make sure that we bring those worlds together, how the cloud is helping customers really accelerate the transformation. So, and one of the key things that we see, and Gartner even addresses that, is the lack of skills, right? Having the knowledge is sometimes challenging. So how we are addressing that from an AWS perspective? So we're working very close, and we have been working for years, for a number of partners that have the industry skills, have the infrastructure skills, have a long tail experience on working on these environments, and have now been certified and have the SAP competence to help customers in these transformations, putting these two worlds together, the SAP world and the AWS together. And this, with these partners and the ecosystem, we see some patterns that are evolving, right? We definitely see customers that are taking, want to arrive to an S/4HANA end state, but there are different paths that they're taking. So we see customers that are doing, and for a number of years doing lift and shift, so basically taking what they have and retire technical debt. You're coming out of all data centers and all infrastructure, and you really need to continue running those solutions. Then we have seen customers that want to run SAP and evolve from a non-HANA database to HANA and get the power of HANA and all the benefits that HANA brings to the table. And of course, we see customers that want to go to an S/4HANA route, right? There are multiple options. And with AWS, what we're trying to see is, hey, how can we help customers in any path, right? What's the best path from them, from their business perspective? Where are they going to get the best value? And that's a business decision that the customer needs to do. What we're seeing happening more and more is customers do a lift and shift to the cloud first. And then when they do that, now they're in the cloud, they can adopt HANA at their own pace. And within that, they can innovate on top of that. So think about a customer, you lift and shift, you're running, you're optimizing your infrastructure, you're making sure that system has better DR, high availability, disaster recovery. You are making sure you are consolidating compute, you're decreasing your cost. At the same time, you're able to clone environments to try to figure out what's your S4 route, making sure you have the right teams in place and you have a clear plan. You can clone those environments to test the S4 functionality and start doing your projects. And at the same time, on the top of that, you can explore new solutions. You can create this system of differentiation that I mentioned before, integrating SAP and AWS, right? So that's kind of the things that we're seeing in the market today. There's a lot of momentum on these paths because definitely customers need to provide more value to their organizations and they combine these paths together. Some of the early results that we're seeing in migration experiences, for instance, right? It's not only the speed that they're moving, like an online retailer moves a whole ECC on Oracle and moving to HANA, took them 29 hours to just do a lift and test, right? And we have seen a lot of customers that want to do that, to experiment and really see what the environment will look like and what's the value there. So definitely interesting. We have other multinational corporations, the CGP space, saying, hey, I need to move a whole BW and Oracle to HANA, doing that with 42 hours. So we see a number of customers that are in that path and the benefits they're getting. Also, we're seeing some of the migration outcomes. So this is on a time perspective, but also you see AIG, right? AIG moved 13 SAP landscapes in 13 months, saved $8 million, and increased performance, right? That's a fantastic story. AIG was able to reduce the cost of the environment by 50%. Deliver Hero, month close, 90 minutes versus 20 hours on premises. So you start to see all these benefits. So the transformation to the cloud is not because the cloud is a cool technology, it's because there's a business value behind that. And both partners and us are working towards making sure you, as a customer, get those benefits. So we also see the innovation angle of this, right? We talk about the migration, the lift and shift, and the transformation to S4. We also see the integration of Zalando, right? How they're extending all these AWS services for SAP to have a better online experience. And Liberty Mutual, how they are using AWS services along with S4 HANA to do real-time financial closing. So you start seeing all this trend of these two worlds coming together, right? This platform for SAP solutions being integrated with all the innovation services that we can bring. So just to nail down on the message here is kind of what makes us different. You know, 100% committed to HANA, and of course, thousands of customers, over 5,000 customers that has put their trust on us, and every single day they run mission critical solutions on us. These 11 years on market, we have a saying at AWS, there's no compression algorithm for experience. That's a quote from Andy Jassy, our CEO. It basically said this experience is based, we are bringing that back experience. We're learning, we have to learn and we continue to learn every single day how to better support these customers. So it's definitely something that we put back to our customers, to you, to see, provide you value and help in your different challenges and business transformation issues. And of course, we have more services, right, than any other cloud provider as we think about your S4 transformation. So, at your SAP cloud platform, we definitely have more services on that space for you to help innovate. So how can we start, right? This sounds good. What do you have right now? How can we start? By all means, you know, we have a number of things here. The first thing is, you know, connect with us, right? I will start saying connect with us, connect with your account team. They're all willing and we have a dedicated account teams for all of you. And also we have a team that is really focused only on SAP and AWS. So reach out to us. You have the email there. We will bring, or you will have maybe a partner of trust. We'll work with them, the competency partner, making sure that, you know, they have all the capabilities to help you. And if you want to start trying things, right, just jump in. Take a stop at the SAP Quick Starts. You know, we just launched this mid last year. You can provision a whole S/4HANA environment in 2 hours, right? That's fantastic. You can play with that. You can decide what size of instance you want to do and really start the journey. One of the key things is, you know, let's start. This is something that we do at AWS. It's a two-way door. Start the journey, try to see, explore what it is. We have teams that will help you in that journey. If it works, it works. If not, you know, we will be an experiment and a learning opportunity. We see a lot of customers, you know, jumping into that, working with us on POCs, working us in moving those environments and trying to see the early results. So with that said, I want to thank you everybody for your time today. I hope that you found this content interesting. And also, I'm open for questions. So I'm going to turn around and see if there are any questions. Thank you. So the first question that I have here is, what's your customer mix across countries? Well, I will say is that across countries, you know, we have customers in every single geo around the world. Customers are adopting running SAP on AWS, regardless of geographic location. We have vast majority, you know, it's very, very clean spread across all geos. So most likely in your own geo, you will have some of your peers that have already done something with us on SAP and AWS. The second question that I have is, what makes Nitro different from any other cloud offering? That's an interesting question. As I was reflecting on Nitro, what Nitro provides is, thinking about customers, right, we make sure that customers receive the full instance, the full performance of that instance to run their most mission-critical applications, right? So we're not taxing that instance. So number one, they allow us, Nitro allow us to provide all the instance. When you virtualize at some level, you have a taxation, so performance is not completely passed to the customer. The other portion that Nitro allows us is not only for putting that to you, but also making sure that connects, right, with all the services. We see other providers that they do collocations, or they do, you know, they try to connect two different instances or our appliances. We don't do that. We have a compute instance completely dedicated, connected with all their services, storage, the EBS security, and all their services at AWS. So that's very different. In what industries do you have more customers? We're very spread across all industries. We don't see a tendency on any particular industries. The typical suspects are with us, retail, manufacturing, some good package, all of them, oil and gas, multiple customers in every single industry right now. So what are some examples of what you are seeing customers do for innovation or business transformation? I think that the big topic that we see is we see customers experiment, right? Experiment a lot. So when you want to transform, you want to be able to flex and try new things. There's a concept we have, which is a two-way door concept. Basically, making decisions, right, that you can try new things, experiment, and then if they work for you, stay there. But if not, you can go back through that door and stay in the previous environment. So I think that's a key example that we're seeing with customers experimenting and connecting things and making sure what addresses their business needs. We also see that with partners. Partners are developing new solutions, integrating and testing those with customers. So we see a lot of innovation happening based on that concept, based on the ability to spin services on demand, on the fly, for a few hours, for a week, and try new things there. So those are the four questions I got. I don't see more questions coming. So with that, I hope that you had some interesting learnings from this webinar, and we're really looking forward to connect with you at your environment, understand your needs, and work together to make sure we can help you, or we can bring value to your business. So with that, thank you very much, and looking forward to seeing you in the world.